Distances in two-dimensional space. When we study shapes, it's useful to have a way of measuring distances. In the real world, we can do this with measuring tape or GPS or what have you. But as mathematicians, we'd like to measure distances in the worlds we imagine as well. One of the more intuitive worlds we can imagine is a plane, or two-dimensional Euclidean space, if you want to be technical. It's much like the world inhabited by Mario and many other side-scrolling video game characters, at least as far as the geometry is concerned. It could be filled with tempting treasures, loyal allies, and fearsome enemies. But the important thing to notice about this world is that if you want to specify a certain location in it, you just have to name two numbers. Namely, if you know where your journey is starting, say at your character's spawn point, then you can name any point in your game's universe just by saying how far you need to move to the right to get there, and how far you need to move upwards. If you need to travel left instead of right, then the first number will be negative. And if you need to move down instead of up, then the second number will be negative. Abstractly, we can think of this world as an infinitely large piece of graph paper with a spawn point or origin marked. If you were building a video game, writing a program to move a character around in this world, then you could name any location you wanted by writing two numbers. Say, 2.75 if you want to be 2.7 blocks to the right of the origin and 5 blocks above it. Or -3, 4.25 if you want to be 3 blocks to the left of the origin and 4.25 blocks above it. And so on. In this way, you're free to populate this world however you like, placing monsters, obstacles, and allies anywhere that suits you. Now then, back to the question of distances. There are many reasons why you might want to know the distance between two points in the game you're building. Say you want your character to fly from one place to another with her jetpack, and you want to know how long it should take, for example. Well, if your character first flies up 3 boxes and then flies up 4, it's easy to see how far she's gone from her starting point. We just add 3 and 4 and get 7. Or if she moves 4 boxes to the right and then 3 boxes to the left, we can subtract 3 from 4 to see that she's now 1 box from her starting point. But if she instead moves 4 boxes to the right and then 3 boxes upwards, then how far is she from her starting point? It's not quite as straightforward. We could figure out the answer in this case by marking the points on graph paper and measuring the distance with a ruler. But we don't want to have to take this measurement every time our character moves. It'd be much nicer to find a general rule for measuring distances. We could put the question like this. Suppose that you start at the origin and then move A boxes to the right and then B boxes upwards. How can you use the numbers A and B to figure out how far you are from the origin? In the next video, we'll talk through this question and one approach to answering it. It's a hard question, and answering it was a great human achievement. But nonetheless, maybe you can figure it out. Before you watch the next video, take some time to think about the question. Daydream about it, draw some pictures, and see if you can come up with an idea or two. Let us know if you think of something you want to share.